Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Let it ride.
Bread and butter for your table, right? Hard for the nigga to stabilize. When would you learn to do it yourself instead of waiting for somebody to save your life? Food for the fire, your bitch ass was born to expire. First to the last, worst to the best is to fill this class.
Ladies and gentlemen, turn around like the So What Morning Show is on fire already. Let it ride. I'm trying to tell you, it's going to be a crazy show today. You better get to your phone lines, 855-878-4652. So What Morning Show on T-Radio V. That's Radio N-T-V. You know how we do. Every week, crazy topics, crazy guests. It's nuts! It's crazy! You know we gotta do this. After everything that has gone on, the topics, the guests, it's about to be crazy. So, as is commonplace, I gotta do the community empowerment segment. But before I do that, let's do this. Books. I always gotta get people to support and read and study and grow and learn. So with that said, really quickly, I'm going to run through these books. Just Listen by my co-host, Dr. Mark Goulston. Don't play yourself. Go get the book and learn how to listen. Now, Doc put all of his knowledge into this book, but yet he has forgotten everything he's written. Please, you get the book and try to remember some of these things. Very powerful book by Dr. Mark Goulston. Great, great, great work. Another book, we always promote this. Dr. Goulston has written 8 or 9 books, I don't know, in growing and counting. Get Out of Your Own Way. Practical lessons for conquering procrastination, fear, envy, obsession, anger, self-pity, compulsion, neediness, guilt, rebellion, inaction. Dr. Mark Goulston. Don't play yourself. Get the book. Again, Uncle Bobby Glanton Smith has produced a haymaker. Listen, Real Men Don't Play. You see Jim Brown on the cover by Bobby Glanton Smith. Go to realmendontplay.com. Get Real Men Don't Play, the book. Very important work, man. Got to do it. Oh, really quickly, my book. Come on now. Daddy needs some shoes. And so do the kids. I am ZoeWilliams.com. Please get there. Support my book. I am ZoeWilliams.com. Follow me, go get it. It's important. And connected to the topic. Oh. Woo. Heavy book. Robert Anton Wilson. Everything is Under Control. Conspiracies, Cults, and Cover-ups. Ye gad. Heavy book. I've read it about 5 times. It's like an encyclopedia of all the world's conspiracies. Very, very heavy book with all the links and resources to research the conspiracy. Now, with that said, books out the way, let's get right into it. Community empowerment segment, and some people will say it's nepotism. I'll just say everybody in my family is cold-blooded, right? We got family that's doing things and have been doing things for many, many years, and I'm bringing another family member in here to support and promote his work, my Uncle Marvin.
Thanks for
having me. What up, Marvin Walker?
Oh, a lot of good things. Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
I'm here with the owner of Arise Hospitality, Mr. Everard Vernon, and he wants to share what we're doing with our future clients.
Wow. Now, tell us what this business and this company is about.
Well, we are the Staples, we're the Black Staples and Office Depot of the world. Whatever you can get in Staples and whatever you can get in Office Depot, we can get it to you cheaper.
Really? Is it the same quality stuff?
Same quality, the same thing. We get it from the same distributor that sells to Staples. Is the same distributor that sells to Office Depot. We're direct to them.
Really?
So the same prices that they buy it for is the same prices that we pay for it.
So you're telling me you carry everything that Staples and Office Depot carries?
Every single thing.
At the same price or less than?
Less than.
So if anybody, after hearing this, continues to buy from Staples, especially black folk, because it's community empowerment, recycling of black dollars, kill yourself. Just go kill yourself if you continue to shop at Staples. That's what I'm going to say.
I got you.
Yes. Right? It's very important that we support businesses that are black owned so we can turn that dollar over. What's the name of the business again?
Arise Hospitality Solutions.
And the website is?
AriseHospitality.com.
What if you're a small black business and somebody wants to get furniture? Do you supply furniture?
We supply furniture.
Really?
At a cheaper price. Any furniture, again, that you see in Staples.
What about printers? What about ink?
Supply all of that.
What about Staples themselves?
All of that and at a cheaper price. It's all for us, it's all about saving money.
Really?
And we can get your products to you in 1 to 2 days.
Wow. So this isn't the Homeboy Shopping Network. We can actually get our stuff.
Everything. Right now, we've got some large companies that we're dealing with. LA County, Atlanta Airport, Burbank Airport, Department of Children's Services.
Really?
Burbank Airport. We supply all these companies right now with products.
Wow.
And they're very excited to have us. When you go on our website and you go into Happy People, it will tell you what they see about us.
Wow, wow. What's the number to your company right now? If there's a small business out there who needs help, who needs hospitality solutions, how do they get to you right now?
855-381-2644.
But if you two are here, who's going to answer the phone?
We've got a receptionist there that will answer the phone for us.
So the business is running.
And also we have the answering machine, so it will pick up whatever messages you have to if she's on the call.
I love it. I love it. I love it. Email?
Email is arisehospitality.com also, each of us name. So you can get us at Everod, E-V-E-R-O-D, at arisehospitality.com, or Marvin at arisehospitality.com, or customer service at arisehospitality.com, or orders at arisehospitality.com.
You're going to give him 18 email addresses. He ain't playing.
Hey, there you go.
You can find us.
Hey, that's beautiful. I love it. Black-owned version of Staples, of Office Depot. Hey, if you're a small black business, or any business for that matter, save some money. Deal with Arise Hospitality, right? Let's do that right now. Hey, I appreciate you guys for coming in. Now, we got to keep moving. Community empowerment. I keep telling you guys, blackmastery.com. If you don't go to blackmastery.com, especially in light of what's been going on in the news, well, I don't have to say his name, Sterling. Especially what's been going on in the news. If you don't get blackmastery.com or Black Mastery, the NLP program, I have a quick question. Did the Clippers? Oh, no, I don't want to get into it. Just get blackmastery.com. Don't play yourself. Go to veronicaconway.com as well. Blackmastery.com, very important. An NLP program that undoes Jim Crow, that undoes the conditioning that black people suffer from in America. Poverty mentality, right? Willie Lynch syndrome. You mean a hypnotic 9-course session that undoes all of that programming? What would a black liberated culture look like? You better get blackmastery.com. Also, go to my homeboy, Ramo Mart. I know, it takes a long time to get the shirts, but he's the homie. We gotta keep supporting him. I'm sorry. He's making them from scratch. We gotta keep supporting him. It's just, you gotta go there. RamoMart.com. Look at, what? Egyptian? What? Yes. Go support the brother right now. And also, I'm wearing some of their clothes today. Hiploose.com. If you saw me last week, I was in a full three-piece tailored sharp as a Ginsu knife suit. Go to hiploose.com and support their movement as well. These are tailors, master tailors, bespoke, fine tailoring. If you need a suit, they will make it from scratch. Hiploose.com to your specifications. They do over 30 measurements for you just so that suit can only fit you. Great stuff. Go do it. Support WeJuice. O-U-I-J-U-I-C-E. WeJuice, the homies from Pasadena, personal trainer, juices, and ships them out all over the world. I'm promoting black business right now because we got to turn the dollars over. If we don't turn the dollars over, we don't have no power, and we just basketball players working for slaves or working for the slave master. Excuse me. Is his name Sterling? We're going to talk about his ass today, I'm telling you. Dockrin, young kid out of Miami, graduated from FAMU, created a service where students can get notes, and he's connected with the professors that actually provide the notes for the classes. He started his business, got a business degree from FAMU. Dockrin, DOCREN.com. Go support the brother. One more thing I gotta support, and then we're done. WBEA.com. They specialize in business training, coaching and mentoring, advertising, networking, advisement and financial analysis, advice and aid, not to mention community outreach, charity, youth empowerment. That's WBEA.com. Don't play yourself. Support the black movement, man. It's going down up in here. I'm turned up. I'm about to take a quick break, and when I come back, the topic, guests, it's about to be crazy. So what mornings? Oh, see you in a minute.
Sean Astin here. You may know me from Goonies, Rudy, The Lord of the Rings, but actually my calling is as a political radio show host. So I am proud to announce that I am bringing my show, Vox Populi Radio, right here to T-Radio V, Radio in TV, Thursdays 12 to 2, live. Did I say that it's live? Live. Call in, tweet in, check in. It's going to be your show.
Hi, I'm Dina Ruggieri, co-author of Children of War, The Mike Rodriguez Story, and founder of Growth Foundation. Growth Foundation is a nonprofit here in Hollywood that provides services to at-risk youth. The vision of Growth is to assist youth in developing the confidence necessary for academic achievement, self-sufficiency, and overall well-being. Not only was Mike Rodriguez a volunteer at Growth Foundation, but he also worked on Skid Row to help other addicts off the streets and into treatment. A portion of each sale of Children of War, The Mike Rodriguez Story, is dedicated to a scholarship fund in Mike's name to help youth achieve their personal and educational goals. Belief in oneself becomes possible when one is believed in. Please visit www.childrenofwarbook.com for more information. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Sheriff John Bunnell. You're watching T Radio. Radio and TV? What?
That was perfect.
Why are you asking me to do this after 12 drinks?
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Yo, hey, now listen here. This is Christina Fulton with my show, which is called Playing Forward, here at T Radio V. Whoa.
I gotta take this call.
Who is it?
President Obama?
Ah! Mr. President, I'm going to tell you something. I'm so happy you called me because over here at T-Radio V, we need your support. Pay attention every Friday at 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Radio V.
Yes, radio and TV. Kyle! Kyle, wake up! I hope I never wake.
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
The president has to go.
And mine eyes have seen the glory.
The shot right now.
Illuminati.
Illuminati.
I sold my soul to the devil.
Wait, throw in some more promos, please.
Promo.
No, we're live. And we're back. It's chaos in here right now.
It's Vietnam running around in here.
Normally we start the show with Dr. G's toolbox. So we don't even play his music right now. We're just going to go to Dr. G. Dr. G, please set up the topic for us today.
What the hell is wrong with me?
Really? Really?
I love the music.
Enough. Dr. G, what's the setup?
Well, the setup is, we're going to be talking about this later in the show, try not to get sucked into your own paranoia. Because a lot of times now there's a lot of reasons to be paranoid. I mean, just because you're paranoid doesn't mean people aren't out to get you. But a lot of times we get sucked into it, and it makes us so overreactive, we don't think about what we're doing. And can we pull up that slide.
Do we have a link here? Let's see the link is talking about. Oh, he's promoting himself.
Yeah, no, click on the top thing. Read the rest of this entry.
That's a hot pick.
Click on that. Don't get sucked into your paranoia. There you go.
Don't get sucked into your paranoia.
Yeah, just click on that.
Doc wants to read to us, you know.
Yeah, okay, so here we go. So part of what causes us to be paranoid is there's a part of our brain, our emotional brain, that can hijack us away from thinking. So when you're stressed, you can still stay focused on what you need to do. But when that crosses over into distress, this part of your middle brain, it's your emotional brain, tends to push you into your reptilian brain, which is fight or flight. And so those tips there, which we'll read, is this is a way to talk yourself down. And there's five steps. It's what we call the how to go from OF to OK, and so OF is fudge, and that's when you say to yourself, "Is this a disaster? I'm screwed. What the hell just happened? I can't fix it. It's all over." Take a deep breath, let it go, and then say, "Oh God." That's the release phase, and you can see what that says. It's a huge mess. I'm going to get stuck with cleaning it up. This always happens to me. I don't swear on the show, you know. Oh geez, the recenter phase is all right. I can fix this, but it's not going to be fun. Oh well. I'm not going to let it ruin my life. And then, okay, I'm ready to handle this, and then take action. So it's a way of talking you off a cliff inside your head.
Wow.
Okay.
So this is the protection that we should use for ourselves when we get caught up in conspiracies? Is that what you're trying to do to us, Doc?
No, when you find yourself in your head and you know you're being really overreactive, I know for me, when I'm overreactive in my head, I don't usually make things better. And so I need to talk myself down to get focused. So that's a way to help you talk yourself down.
So with that said, we're setting up the topic. We're bringing in our special guest. Let me tell you what the topic is today. Get to your phone lines, 855-878-4652. We've got Margot Hudson in the building, Bobby Glanton Smith, Dr. Mark Goulston, and the intellectual comedic irritant Jeff Brown. Let me tell you what the topic is today. It's a dual topic. First hour, we're talking about, is American sports, collegiate and professional, the modern day plantation for the African-American man?
Oh my Lord.
Question mark, right? And then topic number two, the conspiracy show. We're gonna talk about conspiracies, a shocking inquiry into the validity / falsity of propaganda and conspiracies. 1 hour, 2 hour. The first hour, we got to deal with Donald Sterling. Did Donald Sterling just simply tell the truth? He just spoke out of turn, and the rest of the damn owners is pissed off that he pulled the curtain back too soon. He revealed the Oz. We got a special guest on the line right now. Legendary. When I say legendary, I mean legendary. Civil rights author, comedian, activist. The brother is a mentor for all black men in America. He's gonna shed a lot of light, right, on what's been going on. My question is, did the Clippers, the team, the coach, the players, did they miss on an opportunity yesterday to strangle power away from this infrastructure by playing in the game? Should they have played? Should they not have played? I don't know. Let's talk about it. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, on the line, please welcome. Look at everybody waving me off. Why y'all waving me
it's
off?
It's not happening. Hold
Why
on.
Why y'all waving? Don't wave me off.
Keep going.
Ladies and gentlemen, like I said, without further ado, on the line, the legendary brother, we gonna make space for him today.
Yes, sir.
Brother Dick Gregory is on the phone.
All right.
Yes. God bless you.
No, peace God bless you, brother.
All your listeners, and thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, brother. We got questions. Do you mind if I ask a few questions and then we Please. Get out your way?
Please.
Should black folk, as a whole, collectively and aggressively boycott the NAACP?
No, not at all.
Great. Talk to us about the NAACP's support of Donald Sterling and getting him a lifetime award.
Well, let me just say this. There's a whole lot of folks around the world would not send their children to an Ivy League school because Ivy League schools was built by white racist slave owners for their dumb white boys. Well, how many people don't know that? I mean, people don't know that. There's a whole lot of people that believe, you know, well, this white school, I'm privileged. Let me tell you something. If you wrote down 100 of the world-renowned African-Americans, now you can't cheat on that one.
Right.
98 of them would be a product from black colleges.
Mm.
So out of ignorance, you know, people do things. I mean, you have the White House presidents find out things about people that they put in, they didn't vet them right. And so the NAACP, I mean, I don't even know if they have a system to vet people. They just take it from what's generated in the community.
Mm.
So boycotting, you know, why do we have to punish a black organization for something a billionaire white boy did? I mean, when you think about that, you know, my son called me. I was just getting back in the country, and I didn't know this story had broken. He said, you've been saying it for a long time, and I have. If I took over America, the first thing I'd do is ask black folks to apologize to white folk, or the white folks we mad at, you know. They couldn't help us if they liked it.
Come on. Mm. Come on.
You know, some redneck Ku Klux Klaner that can't read or write, ain't never had nothing but hate. And we stupid enough to believe that thug determines public policy? Mm. No, the people who's my enemy is Citizen Roebuck.
Thank you, brother.
Procter
Go
Gamble,
ahead now.
General Motors. But
I
we ain't gonna mess
quiet.
With them because we don't mess with power.
Woo!
Okay? Mm. And so consequently, what has happened now, listen what's happening since this broke. The Supreme Court, the most powerful people on the world, all of them's educated. And 2 weeks ago, they said that, you know, Michigan, University of Michigan was okay and not letting minorities in based on that. I don't hear no big noise out of that, none whatsoever. And so consequently, the Tea Party, white, powerful businessmen in America, are the most powerful humans on the planet.
Mm.
And you think the Tea Party can shut this country down if they didn't want them to? Man, they kill people. Huh? Here's General Motors. They found out that a little bitty piece was messing up and it would kill people, and it cost 42 cents to fix it, and they opt not to spend 42 cents to fix it, so not 12 people's dead, and nobody's calling about that, you know. And so the big money folks, we don't mess with. I was thrilled to see the reaction to what's going on now, and I think it's a lot of things have happened that's caught, and I was really thrilled to see the reaction of athletes. I've never had that much faith in athletes and entertainers to change something. I mean, when the United States goes to war, they don't go out their way to find athletes and entertainers. Okay? They find people who they can train to be killers or not mind being killed. And so athletes, and you know, athlete, entertainer, and entertainer is the only people on the planet that said, if I couldn't get paid for this, I'd do it for free. You never heard a maid say that or a janitor say that. See, what we looking at is we got a culture that since they little bitty children, they've been trained to be a basketball player, football. They're not trained for anything else. I mean, look at Tiger Woods. Since he was 5 years old, he's been trained how to play golf.
Wow.
And when he said he was Capalasia, well, if he would have been in the White House 3 years ago for dinner with 12 of the richest white men in the world, and they left the White House and walked the Pennsylvania Avenue and turned left, and three racist cops turned the corner and say, hit the ground, nigga. How many of you think it would have failed? Him. Although he said he wasn't. He was Capalation. And the other white boy standing with him, they said, Tiger, why are you on the ground? They didn't even hear it.
They didn't even hear it.
and so where we are today, it's the more consciousness, this consciousness waking up. Consciousness waking up, because in this so-called democracy, everybody's looking for that airplane from Malaysia. Well, I would go get Tiger Woods, since he said he's Capalation. Maybe he knows the secret. But you ask yourself a simple question. Right now, they can bug your phone and hear everything you say anywhere on the planet from a satellite. Now you tell me a plane damn near two blocks long is missing? And so when you say should African Americans boycott the NAACP, let me tell you something. The word nigger I didn't invent. Okay? And when somebody sit at the desk and decided the word nigger wouldn't be used anymore, it wasn't one black person sitting at that table to make that decision. Okay? Now let me tell you how it works. If you're walking down the street and a white dude walk up to you and say, nigger, and then hits you, that's a federal case. Okay? That is a race crime. Okay? If you walk up to you and say N-word and hits you, it's not a federal case. Why was that word banned with black folks? So if any of you all listening saw Django Unchained, and you also The Butler, and you also Abraham Lincoln, they use nigger anytime they want.
Come on, cow, pig, chicken, nigger.
To use nigger, but tell me not to use it, huh? Wow. And then we buy into it. Now, I'm 82 years old, born and raised in St. Louis. We didn't see no white folks. Remember, television wasn't created when I was a little boy. The only white folks we saw in our neighborhood was bill collectors or white folks trying to sell you something. They was on their best behavior. They wouldn't call you no nigger. So the first time I was called a nigger was by a black person, and we just laughed, right? Because nobody ever taught me what a nigger looked like. I look in the mirror, I didn't see nigger. Now I tell you, if you was black, what you better not call me black. I could see my blackness, and the fight was on. Okay? Oh, I had a guy had a big fight. A brother called him, we in grade school, yellow nigger. And he wasn't fighting over the nigger. He's fighting over the fact yellow. He was yellow.
Mm.
And so what you call me, the only part that's true is my yellowness.
Mm.
And let me tell you something else that we tolerate, black folks. All of them talking about the word nigger. It shouldn't be said. It shouldn't be this. It shouldn't be that. I'm 82 years old. I've been married to a black woman for 55 years. 99% of black women I've been around all my life, I never heard them say the word nigger. That's a man thing. So maybe it's a sex thing, okay?
Good point.
Hear me. Because white folks don't know they're not around me. And when they talk about nigger, they think, if you listen to the rap song where the brothers are saying nigger, how many women do you hear saying nigger? Don't rap, huh?
Not talking
so
to each other.
Anything they throw us, we follow. And stop, like, honky. Where's the word honky come from? See, prostitution in America was created to benefit white men, okay? And I said that one day in St. Louis, and the guy on TV said, well, you mean black men don't have prostitutes? Oh, yeah, I have it. She's my sister. I get them when you threw with her for free.
Woo.
Now, here's the way it works. Prostitute houses.
Brother Gregory, one of our panelists has a question for you. Brother Bobby.
Well, wait, let me finish this here.
Mm-hmm.
Let me finish this.
Go ahead, brother. Finish it.
Prostitute houses, black community. Black folks couldn't go to them. I went to Southern Illinois University. 30 miles from there was a whorehouse run by black folks, owned by black folks couldn't come. It was for whites, okay? And let me tell you where that started.
Mm-hmm.
If I come out of my neighborhood, none of these black folks know me, huh? None of them know me. Nobody can go back and tell nothing, huh? Hmm. And so prostitute houses were set up in black communities. So when I came in there, I pulled up at the number 2222, and I honked the horn. And the big 6'9" black man would come out and escort me and my party into the whorehouse and then drive my car and park it. When they pulled up, they honked. Honk, honk. That's where the word honky come from, okay? And so the more we understand things, the great thing about what's happening across the country now with this basketball craziness, now somebody suggested that a black person by the team. Well, if I had anything to do with it, I would have in the calls, anybody can buy the team, but if we find out they was fronting for somebody else. In other words, if this white man sold the team to somebody that he was still the owner, then he would lose the team without paying a nickel.
Wow.
You find a whole lot of black folks that would come in and front the team. Okay, first you find out how much is it worth. It's just like when I look at these mega churches, $40-90 million. How can they get these loans when General Motors couldn't get a loan back then? So what is that church really about, huh?
Wow.
Okay, yeah. And so consequently, when you stop and see, I'll take this other question after this. The Supreme Court, not some redneck Klansman, determined that affirmative action do not have to be used in the state of Michigan when you think about a student getting admitted to the school. Okay? Now, so we have the power. Hear me good now. We don't have the money, but we have the power. If we could organize, and that organize means just word of mouth, word of mouth, huh? That we will no longer send our children to a Michigan college. Now, let me tell you something. The University of Texas football budget, not the sports budget, is $100 million. When you send that ripple through all them colleges, by Bear Bryant, one of the most racist, outrageous folks in sports, at the University of Alabama, he became a legend. And they said, Coach, at the press conference, when do you think you'll have a Negro on the team? He said, a Negro will be on my team over my dead body.
Mm.
Then all at once, integration hit. And he started drafting blacks. And they asked him, why'd you change your mind? He said, because I wanted to win. Okay? I wanted to win. And so if we could just start word of mouth, Stevie Wonder, when that whole thing here with Trayvon, he didn't go to no committee. He said, I am not working the state of Florida as long as they have
that
Daniel Ground line. Now, he didn't meet with, and listen, millions of dollars he lost by that decision. But nobody calls in and say, thank you, Stevie.
Right.
Oh, what a beautiful, they're arguing about who have done this or who haven't done that or who haven't, should black folks boycott the end of, no. Black folks should go out, those that can afford it, and buy a Stevie Wonder album once a month, and if you can afford it, once a week, and give it to somebody, okay?
Wow.
Brother Gregory. Brother Gregory.
So again, I'm saying, we have the power. Let me tell you something. The Masters was just 2 weeks ago, and do you know they lost money? Why? Because Tiger had an operation, right?
Mm.
And he wasn't there.
Wow.
And so a whole lot of white folks didn't show up. Now, let me tell you what it's like. When Tiger's there, there's white folks show up and hate him. They just come to see him lose.
Wow.
Okay? So all the white folks there is not there to see him win. But if he's not there, they have no reason of coming.
So, Brother Gregory, really quickly, we got fellow comedian Corey Holcomb in the building. I'm sure he's a big fan of yours, and he.
Wait, first. I do 200 dates a year.
You do 200 dates a year.
What? Most of the new comics, I've never seen them. Where would I see them?
Oh man, he's definitely a big fan of yours. And then we have a brother who's really tight with Jim Brown in the building, Bobby Glanton Smith. He wanted to ask you a question as well.
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, brother. My question is, why is it inappropriate to hold the NAACP accountable for taking coffee money from a man who in 2009 had already established in a lawsuit that he lost that he had no regard for black people whatsoever, and they were prepared to give him another award until this came out.
He had been in court before this week.
Yes, sir. I knew it. I was there in 2000.
Did you tell me? Hold it now. I put my life on the line for this. So that's who you talking to. You ain't talking to some punk that's off the street dealing with emotions. I'm saying everybody. I heard Graham Gumbel yesterday said, he said he knew it. Well, this is the first time you saying it. That's what I'm saying. Okay? That's what I'm saying. A whole lot of people have made mistakes. You know,
mistake.
79% of all marriages in America end up in divorce. So it's a whole lot of people make mistakes. Okay?
All due respect, sir.
I thought that was a perfect, what it is out there now, we out there now. Okay? I didn't hear nobody say, let's boycott Christmas until Congress come in and undo what the Supreme Court did. It's always easy to punish black. If you, I tell y'all who's listening, do me a favor. One day this month, go to traffic court. 98% of everybody in traffic court is black.
Black
folks just today. Ain't doing that much more speeding than white folks. Okay, so it's always been easy. If my cousin, I've got a little trifling cousin in St. Louis, if he walked into Hilton and killed 42 white folks, they're going to give him the electric chair. Even if they don't have capital, they'll invent it. If Prince Charles's old drug addict children come over here and kill 100 white folks, if you believe that boy going to get the electric chair, you need to go to a mental hospital. I'm saying it's always been easier to funnel black folks. Now, what you could do, if we were members of the NAACP, you could make a phone call
to the
NAACP and said, I'm going to take my membership back. Okay?
I done did that already.
I'm part of the group, huh? All right, I'm saying, when you part of something, now let me tell you something. You got black folks listening today that have carried their children to Disneyland to see a rat. But they haven't been to King's grave or to his tomb to say thanks, because he not died, you wouldn't be welcome in Orlando, Florida, okay?
Oh. All due respect, brother.
No, no. All you have to do is just say it. You don't need no due respect.
All right, well, I get right to it then. I got colored on my birth certificate, and I drank out of that water fountain myself. I've made sacrifices, and I have a right to say the NAACP can be held accountable for taking coffee money from a racist.
You asked me my opinion, didn't you?
And I just gave you mine.
You go ahead and do it, huh?
I just gave you mine.
You go ahead and organize people. You can do that. Don't sit here. How many times have you been on a show and think Stevie Wonder? That's what I'm talking about.
I went to
you have the power to do that.
Brother,
okay?
You got the wrong, you got the right string, but the wrong yo-yo.
And all I'm saying is, well, you got ways to do it. I tell you what, if I got caught in bed with a chicken last night, all y'all would know about it, right? Because we got a network when we want it. Huh?
All right, mommy.
Yeah.
Okay?
Let me put my
I'm the one
back.
Released to pick you with Ron Brown with the bullet in the back of his chicken. Head. It never was a plane wreck. Me and five other people put our money together, and we the ones that called the Kennedy King assassination investigation, okay, to be investigated, okay? So I'm just saying, we can do anything on emotions, well, go ahead and do it. Do it. You don't have to get approval. Stevie Wonder didn't have to make one phone call to decide he wasn't going to work there. And you can do the same thing. Just call your brothers and your cousins. You know what we can do to change this country?
Excuse
How
me,
come
brother
we not
Bradley?
Talking about punishing somebody from police brutality?
Because, hey, the reason a lot of people don't think to talk bad about the Caucasian people is because they program to think, or they program to go after the black people because it's easier. It's easier to say something bad about the black people.
Well, there's no
than
real
to stand
repercussion.
Up boldly and say something bad about the white people. That's why they do that. But yo, Dick Gregory, this is Corey Holcomb. I want to let you know that I appreciate you and everything you do. I know you a soldier who really has done it and not said it. You've done it. So yeah. I got mad
Thank
respect
you.
For you, man.
Yeah.
Likewise. Let me back up on what you just said. There's so much stuff that they programmed us that we're not even aware of. Do you know, being an entertainer, you go all over the world. Look, it ain't another man on this planet that called his woman strong. Okay?
Wow.
You a
wow.
strong sister.
Wow.
But they'll show you their beautiful car. Wow. Let me show you this beautiful car. But the sister, why? Ooh. Because a white racist system had programmed me that the black woman is ugly. And then programmed her, she's ugly.
That's true.
Now follow this. All over the world and all through your travels, there's not another woman except a black woman go to a place that's called a beauty parlor. I've been so convinced that she's ugly, and she's been so convinced that she's ugly, she goes someplace they think gonna make her beautiful. If I go to the eye doctor, I think something wrong with my eye. If I go to the dentist, something wrong with my tooth. If I go to the foot doctor, something wrong. And we not even conscious of that, okay? The strongest two forces in the history of America is the black woman and the black church.
That's it.
And when we black folks understand that, I don't understand how a black woman gets so upset with a black man with a white woman, because I say this, all you do is go to Madison Square Garden. You an entertainer. How many black men you see come in with white women? Go to the Super Bowl and see how many black men is there with a black woman. So what have they done to my sister to scare her so bad about a black woman, a white woman, okay? I've never had sex with a white woman. Ain't got nothing to do with my love for a black woman. I'm scared of them, man. Like I said, I'm 82 years old. I used to go to the movie, look at Wolfman, Dracula, Frankenstein, and all of them came out of a white woman's belly, man. What I want to go in there for?
Wow.
Oh, listen, Dick, brother
wow.
Dick, we got to take a quick break.
Damn.
But when we come back, we're going to go deeper into the conspiracies. We're going to go deeper into this Donald Sterling Clipper thing. Man, the brother... Dick Gregory
is dropping
bombs, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back. The panel is going to weigh in. Yo, this show is crazy. We'll be back in 2.2.
Ah.
Laura, host of Miss Laura's Civil Wars. We do it every Saturday at 10 a.m. We talk about what's in the news that everybody's fussing and fighting about this week, because y'all are rude. We have a roundtable of media experts, and we bring in celebrity guests from the world of entertainment. So join us on Miss Laura's Civil Wars every Saturday at 10 a.m. on TRadioV.com. Radio and TV.
Okay, don't smell my armpits.
Outstanding warrant for her arrest. Outstanding ticket.
Yeah, yeah.
Outstanding warrant for her arrest.
No, go ahead.
Shit, you keep it up, you're gonna get your own show here, dude.
Oh my God, I could just climb up this thing like a cat.
My second wife over there.
Let me do that again, because those words weren't even in that script. Toya hauled off to a nearby station.
Hold on.
So you smelling my armpits, making it seem... No, you were smelling under here.
When you go downstairs, you'll see something on the street that'll make you...
Squirrel!
Get a little
I meant
closer.
Downstage, so you're not...
All right, here we go. I'm gonna do it for real this time. Okay.
And then there was the time when my biological father called in.
That's where right. We're catching you up on all your entertainment news and the latest hot topics, you son of a...
That was good.
It's your boy.
You threw me.
I'm real, and I'm... Chance, aren't you?
Let's do it again.
Come on, baby.
What's up, baby?
Shh. Okay.
T-Radio V. Radio and TV. Okay.
What happened to your arm?
Oh, you didn't do
that. Wow, come
I
on.
I forgot. I'm gonna get it.
How can you forget? Listen, we've done it three times.
The laughter makes it worthwhile.
Hey, what's up? I am Scott.
And I am Ken. We are not the Chemical Brothers, but we are the Crystal Method. And you are watching T-Radio V.
What's up, y'all? It's E. Don.
And I'm Dave Pink.
And we are the hosts of the Real Talk Show that airs every Tuesday.
You so serious?
Real life, real topics, real subjects.
Shop Talk, Diva Pink. Yes.
Real people.
Taking over.
Your homie Don Juan providing the vibes.
Oh, yeah, he does every week. Oh,
man, we need y'all to tune in every Tuesday, 6 p.m. to 7. T-Radio V. Radio and TV.
It is radio.
Radio and TV.
You're crazy.
Let's do another one.
Drums. Do you like drums?
Drummers.
Tell them about the show. Come on.
Drummers. Well, we like interviewing only the best drummers in the world on Drum Smack TV.
The best.
Right? The best. Only the best. Well, only the best.
And then Brad. Brad. We interview Brad every week. But we actually talk about drums and drumming and drummers.
Check it out. It's an informal, interactive show that's all about drums, drummers, and drumming. Please check it out. It's pretty rad.
Smacking.
That's a good one.
Smacking.
That's the drum.
That's a smack.
Drum.
Smack.
Are we all smacking?
Smack.
Only on T-Radio V, Drum Smack TV. Watch it. It's funny and good and all that stuff.
And smack.
And Brad will be there too.
That's right.
Let's Get Digital, Wednesday, 6 p.m. on T-Radio V LA.
Crazy Bone would never do this.
Well, I guess it.
Yo, what's up, y'all? This your boy Crazy Bone.
Man, I'm the bum Keith G, man.
And whenever you're sitting at home and can't shake the monkey off your back.
Yeah.
Then just know every Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m.,
right.
You can tune in to the Quick Fix and get your fix on, man.
Right here on TRadioV.com, baby.
Radio and TV.
So how they gonna see us on the radio then?
Radio, I don't know. Or is it TV and radio?
But it's
one of them.
I gotta figure this radio and TV thing out though, bro. I don't understand. I'm gonna tell my mom how she gonna see
get
us.
Get it together.
Hi, I'm Moby, and you're watching T-Radio V.
Hi, this is Slim Jim Phantom, and you got the big beat. We're gonna take this music into the 22nd century. We deal exclusively in rockabilly music. Elvis Presley, Jerry Lee Lewis, Carl Perkins, Chuck Berry, Little Richard, Richie Valens, Wanda Jackson, Janis Martin, the Everly Brothers, Johnny Cash, and everybody else. Thank you so much for supporting the big beat here on T-Radio V.
I'm Zoe Williams.
And I'm Dr. Mark Goulston.
I'm Jeff Brown.
And we make up the Zoe What Morning Show. You can find us here on TRadioV.com every Monday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. I make you think.
He makes you laugh, and if I get a chance, I'll help you change.
Or make you cry with his attempts at humor.
Radio NTV.
Can you relate? We'll make it happen.
Look at Jeff. What you doing?
Were you mumbling to yourself?
Hey, back there mumbling.
To them. To them.
T Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Hello and welcome to The Ink Spot, the show where we talk about books. Today on the show, we'll be discussing the book, $40 Million Slaves. You said that even with the title, $40 Million Slaves, that is a contradiction. It's an oxymoron.
If you're making $40 million, how can you classify yourself as a slave?
A slave is an individual that has no power. And that's, I don't, you know, they're not free to make their own decisions. You know, now they're telling them what they can do on and off the court. My job can address how I address my attire, how I speak at my job, which is fine. But like right now, they have no say-so over what I want to do or what I say. With the basketball players, once they step off the course, they say, well, you still represent us, so you can't do that. Well, that's what slaves were. When you go out here, you represent your master, so you can't talk back to that white man. You can't do this. And that's just what they've done to these athletes. They put restrictions on them outside of the game.
Michael Jordan stood for what he wanted to stand for. Like, people have a tendency to say, well, if I feel this way, you got to feel this way. You can't make me out to be what you want me to be. Let me be what I want to be.
But he didn't express an opinion at all, so that means he really didn't
stand
for anything.
No, he didn't express his opinions. Even when they got the North Carolina thing at the school, they wanted to make that monument for that that teacher there.
His mother was.
Right. Said, well, why don't you just build a library for everybody, not just her?
If they're going to say, hey, let's build a monument to black folks, and then Michael Jordan said, well, let's include everybody, wouldn't that be an example of being
neutral? Michael Jordan was that house Negro that made the best dinner in the world that all the white folks love, and everybody came over, and because of that, they gave him his own cabin, they gave him his own little farm, they gave him everything else. But he still couldn't leave the plantation. He still had to remain neutral and everything. When the white folks at the dinner table talking, Jordan, you need to shut up and not say nothing.
Ooh. Amen. Wow. And hallelujah.
Wow. Yeah,
every word of it.
Is the modern day black athlete just a high paid slave?
Look at him talk. Mm.
Is he just a high paid slave?
Without question.
Look at him talk when they talk about what's happening right now. They're very the way they talk, you can tell, I don't want to say nothing to make nobody mad, but I am a little upset about what
Donald Sterling said. Because they like that mansion. They like riding that Bentley.
Even Stephen A. Smith.
That son of a bitch.
He will, look, I got respect for him, but at the same time, you can't say nothing that's real. And the other dude, the white guy, what's his name?
Skip
Bayless. Yeah. It's so funny because he act like he mad when people say racist stuff. But the greatest example of Skip Bayless to me is, I remember one day Farrakhan said he had this little dog named Lucky on the farm, and he said Lucky was a real politician because he played with the cats and the chickens and everybody. You know what I'm saying? Everything be cool, but when the other dogs come around, he run with them and kill the cats and the chickens and everything. I was like, that's the best example I heard to describe somebody like Stephen A. Smith. Wow. I mean the white guy, Skip Bayless. Wow. They'll run with you, but when that shit really hit the fan, they're going to be with them.
You know, I'm not gonna weigh in this discussion. That's
you scared?
Sure.
Don't be scared.
I know what it's like to feel like a minority here. You know, but I want to throw something out as a possible solution.
Okay? Go ahead.
This could be the perfect storm for crowdfunding. Mm. We could crowdfund the Clippers, and you could own a part of the Clippers for $5. You put that out there, you could crowdfund and. It's the perfect storm for African American. What? There's something called Kickstarter. There's all these sites where you can donate money to be part of something bigger than yourself. This is a huge opportunity, not just for African Americans. It's for white people that want to stand up and against whatever.
I vehemently disagree with that.
Go ahead, Jeff. Why?
Why? Because we have everything when it comes to the NBA. We have all the speed. We have all the power. We have all the, okay, you can have a team full of white boys. You can play. You're just not going to win. Mm. In my opinion, the Clippers should die. And I'll go further to that in my
Well, let me say this really quickly. Brother Gregory I have a question for you and the entire panel. I have a question for you and the entire panel, and that is, I'm sitting here looking at Bobby. Bobby Glanton has a T-shirt on with a picture of the famous great Jim Brown.
That dude.
Is this a seminal? Could this be a seminal moment for CP3 and Blake Griffin to take that mantle? Could they do something where they stand for something that's bigger than the game, something called integrity, and forfeit some games so they can really show that they have power? Because most brothers and sisters in America don't know the difference between money and power. So is this a seminal moment that they might be missing out on right now?
You know, one of the problems with us, the reason America was this filthy, ungodly human power, the reason they win every war, they ain't never went into the neighborhood and want punks and sissies who can't fight to be part of their team. It's derogatory to Jim Brown. Somebody posed the question when you came back on, or athletes, modern day slate, or some athletes, are you including Muhammad Ali? That gave up more money than some black neighborhoods give up for liberty? How can you say, all you got to do is say, most, but don't say what you just said. But on a radio show, you're free to say anything you want. That's why when America want to solve a problem, they don't go to no radio show. When America decided they was going to the outer space, they didn't get people that loved America. They went and got scientists and didn't care where they came from. Mm. Okay? If a house catch on fire today and your family's in, you just going to go get people off the street, or you going to get people who willing to give up their life? People got a right to be scared. Are you crazy? Mm. People got a right to do certain things. Huh? And so when we sit and run that whole blanket, that's a slave mentality. That's a slave mentality. Listen at this. Coca-Cola is in court right now in northern Dallas because they found out something that most folks didn't know, that all soda pop have an expiration date on it.
Yep.
And when it passed that expiration date, you're supposed to throw it away. A group of black and white that had been doing it for Coca-Cola for years reported it to the federal government. And here was the headline to the New York Times. Workers contend Coke sent old sodas to poor neighborhoods. Now, poor neighborhoods be white, you know. But when they get down into it, they talk about there were Negro neighborhoods. Now, is the pharmaceutical company doing the same thing? Is the pharmaceutical company doing the same thing? And so you listen to black folks talk about, well, these black talking about bitches and hoes. Well, wait a minute. I'm 82 years old. Did you get upset, you old black folks, with James Brown, the hardest working man in show business, shake your money maker? A money maker, he was supplying, is a vagina, a sex organ. The universal God, not the church, gave you to reproduce another God. Ooh. And when you sell it, it's called a money maker. Y'all wasn't upset over that. When James Brown said, I'm black and I'm proud. No, he should have said, now I'm black and I'm proud, because he used to put so much comb and bullshit in his hair, he looked like something in a zoo. And so, what do you mean, I'm black? No. Now I'm black and I'm proud. Okay? And so when you stop and think about, they worried about the little black boys with their pants below their butt. The mob never wore their pants below their butt. Hitler never wore his pants below his butt. The people that killed Jesus never wore their pants. You always can pick on somebody who ain't gonna hurt you. But I can't hear y'all saying stuff about the mob, okay? I can't hear you saying stuff about the government. The mob sent out a hit on, the FBI sent out a hit on me in Chicago. But what they didn't know before Hoover's, it got telex to Chicago FBI. I had a copy before they did, And it says, use mob to kill Dick Gregory. Okay? And so I got on the
Brother TV. Gregory,
And I dared him, huh? I dared him. If the God I pray to can't protect me against filth, then I'm praying to the wrong God.
Now, Brother Gregory, I got to agree with you that black people look for easy targets. I personally have spoken out about the mob only from this place, is that I don't understand why black people, especially black rappers, name themselves after people who, in movie after movie, have said they don't like black people. I've spoken out about a lot of other things, and I'm going to have to tell you, the one thing I disagree with you with is that sagging is horrible. Sagging
is what?
It's horrible. My sons are not allowed to do it because, to me, it is an earmark that you don't know who your daddy is or you got a problem with him, because that's the only way.
Wait a minute, brother. Let me just say this to you. It's a sexist thing. If women wore their drawers that low, we wouldn't have no complaints.
No,
okay?
We wouldn't. No, we wouldn't.
Don't hear me. Hear me.
They are wearing them that low.
No, I do. No. As a regular. I see what he's saying. I see what you're saying, and I agree with you because, Brother Gregory, I don't mind seeing panties. However, I don't want to see no dude's boxers, and I believe I speak for most of, and it's not even, I'm going to keep it a black thing.
But
as a black man, I'm appalled by it.
But the equivalent of that that the sisters do is the mirror bathroom pick.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I wish women would say
the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Huh? You should start the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Start it. Start sagging.
Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
He dealt with drugs. And you see a Muslim, they don't smoke. They don't drink. They don't use alcohol. And yet, how many black folks do you know have invited them into their community, into their church, to explain to us how you did this? So you're not talking to no fool.
Exactly.
I spend millions of dollars of research, okay? So I'm not coming from emotions, huh? When look, if you go out and get somebody that can't read or write, then why do you expect them to read a book? First, you go out and find out who the rappers were, huh? Where'd they come from? And what are they trying to say? All that filth they be saying, they didn't learn it when they got grown. They heard that at home. Maybe not from the mother or father. Somebody was there that heard it. But all I'm saying is, you ain't never seen a drug pusher stand on a corner with his pants below his butt. But I don't hear, I always get the one person that hates it and talk about, I always get the one white boy that swear he ain't a racist, okay?
Wow.
I always get that one. But I'm saying, you people listen to the radio. They ain't heard nobody say thanks to the Muslims, thanks to the Nation of Islam. You see them out there selling their newspaper. They didn't make money and run. So if they stood there and don't need it, what's their formula, huh? How many times do you see Muslims on shows like this explaining how did you do it, huh? This is a game we play. And somewhere, little by little, because of shows like this, there was a time you couldn't have a show like this on. It'd be cut off in between a joke, okay? The progress that's being made, the progress that's being made is this. First, Sears and Roebuck didn't give me nappy hair. Redneck nigger-hating crackers didn't give. It came from the same God that created mountains. It came from the same God that put the whole universe there. And are you stupid enough to tell me these white folks done mess your head up enough that you would try to change something God made?
Wow.
Who is you?
Are you crazy?
Who is you?
Let me tell you something.
Who is you?
When
you say you, who are you referring to?
Huh?
When you say you is stupid, who are you referring to? Anybody in this room?
You what?
Not nobody in this room. It ain't personal. He's saying
no. Hey, wait, no. You have to explain me. I'm talking to me.
That's what he's saying. That's right. I asked you. I asked you, who are you talking about?
You asked who?
Oh, well, you weren't talking to me. Okay.
No, obviously not.
So I'm talking to you now.
So
now what?
So let's do this.
How did my mama get in this conversation?
Because I brought her in.
Oh, shit. See, now that's what I want to say.
I know exactly who I am, and I know who my mama is, and you don't know her, and you ain't got a right to put her in this conversation.
That's right. Well, I did put her in, so what you going to do
about it? What's in that?
Oh, my God.
Okay, so listen. Let's come on now. We respect each other here. Let's all stay together.
I'll tell you what we need to do. We need to get Uncle Bobby in one corner and Dick Gregory in the other.
No.
And take two MMA guys.
Jeff.
That ain't right, man.
No. This is what we're going to do.
That's not right.
We're going to stay on topic.
Yeah. Okay.
We're going to come back.
And leave my mama.
Because it's not about us going at each other.
Yeah.
The purpose of this show is to get knowledge out into the community. And like Brother Dick Gregory just said, we need to respect the platform a little bit more. Because like he said, they don't have shows like this everywhere. And
no way.
Back in the day, this wouldn't have been on at all. So let's not turn this into theater. Let's get back to the point. And the point is, African Americans in America, we're suffering. We're the lowest in every statistical number right now across the board. My point is, how do we use this defining moment of a owner of a sports team that obviously gives two shakes of a fat rat's ass about his players because of their ethnicity? How do we take this moment and use it for the highest good of all black athletes in professional sports? And then after that question is answered, we're going to go into our second topic of the show. Anybody have any comments on that?
Yes.
I know.
There you go. Go have at it.
I think we constantly as a people missed the boat on opportunities to step up and unify. And to me, again, I don't think that the owner should be called out on the carpet in any way, shape, or form by the NBA, by any sanctioning body, no, it's very, very simple. Anything that is ignored will go away. If black people as a whole start ignoring the things that come up and say, I don't like you, I don't want you, I don't need you, then turn your back on it. There is not one corner of business in the world that can survive if black people were to entirely turn their backs on it. If we would entirely turn our backs on the Clippers, entirely, if these cats played their hearts out for the rest of their contract and went to another team, if no other black athlete for 100 years would ever decide to play for the Clippers. If black people said, if it's a Clipper game on, I'm not watching. Oh no, I'm gonna watch. And every commercial, I'm not buying that car. I'm not drinking that soda. Then you make a change. Trying to buy the team, trying to do all this other, that's arranging deck chairs on the Titanic.
Well, this is what we need to do right now. We got to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to shift topics into the conspiracy side of things. And I know Brother Dick Gregory has a wealth of information on that side as well, and we're going to pose all of those questions that we have. Today's show is crazy. We'll be back in 2.2, 855-878-4652 at T Radio V Radio NTV. We'll be back.
This is your man Money B from Digital Underground, inviting everyone to join me for my new show, The Going Way Back Show with Money B, every Tuesday, 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, right here on T-Radio V. Join me, Ty Teezy, and DJ Always to give you your favorite hip-hop from back in the day. Right here on T-Radio V.
Hey guys, I'm Destiny. Check out my show, Destiny's EDM Power Hour, every Tuesday at 4 p.m. here on T-Radio V. Every week, I talk about all things in the electronic dance world, including the hottest songs, DJs, latest news, and random facts, including how to dance on the moon when the beat drops. Every Tuesday at 4 p.m. here on T-Radio V, radio in TV.
Hey guys, I'm Danny Boy.
And I'm Knocko Nolan.
See what I mean? Hey guys, I'm Danny Boy O'Connor.
And I'm Knocko Nolan.
And we're the Del...
Fuck! Oh, that's not written down.
All right, well, I'm going to do it my way.
Okay.
No, it's okay. Watch us as we uncover. And we're the Delta Bravo Urban Exploration Team. Join us every Friday from 7 to 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Or 10 to midnight for our East Coast friends.
Watch us as we uncover, discover, and explore music, movie, and true crime locations. The Delta Bravo Show every Friday, 7 p.m. right here on T Radio V. Radio and TV. Just put your hand just like that.
Andy D on T Radio V.
Bing, bang, bing, boom, right?
Yeah.
Andy D on T Radio V. Bobbity, bibbity, bobbity, boom. Andy D on T Radio V.
The Andy Dick Show, Wednesdays from 4 to 6 p.m. on T Radio V.
Wow!
So but Paul, we'll do it better when the show actually starts. Yeah,
no. Smoking big fatties. Hi, I'm Britta.
And I'm Taylor.
And together, we're the Canna Bitches. Watch our show every Wednesday at 12 p.m.
or high noon.
It's a full hour of comedy, cannabis, and interviews.
And us being really stoned.
Hey, like, Britta.
Yeah. What's long and firm and filled with goodness?
Ooh, I'm thinking dirty thoughts, but
I'm thinking a big fat J.
Ooh! That's right. Every Wednesday, watch the Canna Bitches get super stoned at 12 p.m.
Right here at T Radio V.
It's radio and TV.
I want my MDB.
Yeah.
I want my MDB. I love me some MGB.
Of course they do.
It's the Michael DeBar Show, Thursdays at 3 p.m. on T Radio V.
I think he really loves me.
T Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Well, them Jews losing their power of Israel. Why don't you learn? Why don't you study them? Evidently, they ain't breaking no law. They ain't going to jail. So why don't we study it and do the same thing for Africa? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Nelson Mandela, 6 weeks ago, they had a vote to name a city street after him in Cape Town, and they voted it down. And y'all think black folks run South Africa? The newspaper is owned by white folks. They did a horrible article when Nelson Mandela was president and said he wear these native clothes, these loud shirts, African shirts. He need to stop, huh? Well, anybody tell Jews about them little caps they wear? Anybody tell Orthodox folks about the little outfits they wear? Mandela. Oh, man, every time he had a birthday, I was with the Negroes and went over there to his birthday party. And then all at once, I stopped when he could forgive all them white folks. They was doing head transplants and all kind of experiments with them black folks. He could forgive them, but he couldn't forgive Winnie?
Wow, wow.
You thug punk, who are you? Who are you?
Oh, Gregory. Brother Gregory, oh, wow. Okay.
You could forgive them. Mm-hmm. And promise them if they come before your committee and tell you the truth, that's how come we know what they was doing. Mm. Huh?
Yes, sir.
And you can forgive them because they say if you come before us, we will wipe it out. If you don't come before, you can be arrested anytime. So they all came. Matter of fact, they lied. Some of them said they did too much in case they forgot something. But he couldn't forgive Winnie? And y'all sucker for that? Something wrong.
Wow.
No more parties for me.
Wow. That's heavy. That's a heavy piece by the brother Dick Gregory. Again, I think conspiracies, propaganda, control every aspect of our daily lives, our perception, how we view the world, our worldview. Everybody here on the panel, Margo, Bobby, Dr. G, Jeff, of course, Corey Holcomb, and brother, legendary civil rights activist and comedian, author extraordinaire, just overall sage in our community that we value very deeply. Brother Dick Gregory is on the line with us as well. Listen, huh? Oh, absolutely. Corey Holcomb wants to ask you a question, Brother Dick Gregory.
Let me just say this. You mentioned community. We do not live in a community. A community is where you control your cops, you control your education, you control your banks, you control your businesses. We live in a hood, and a hood is something you put on your head when you're trying to hide something.
That's deep. Okay. That is,
so
that's
when we
magical.
Start turning things around, here in Washington, D.C., where I am, if they had a minority business meeting today, if they had a minority meeting, that should be for white folk because they're in the minority. That pertains to us, okay? And don't care how little or how big you are, when you hear the word minority, that means you. And so I grew up, and let me say this, and then I'll listen to the question. My mother, if she walked in your studio right now, she's been dead since the early 50s, you would think God just spit her out. That's how beautiful and conscious and sweet and spiritual. But if you tried to convince my mother Jesus Christ wasn't a Christian, she'd stomp you to death. Her ignorance didn't permit her to know Christianity never happened till 300 years after Jesus Christ was dead. Okay?
Amen.
All right? Another thing is, they were celebrating Christmas and Easter 3,000 years before Jesus Christ was born. Martin Luther King was assassinated on April the 4th, and every year we celebrate that day. JFK was shot in Dallas on November the 22nd. And nobody asked, how do one year Easter come in April, another year comes in March? You can't be killed in two different months. The reason is Easter has nothing to do with that. Easter is the first Monday after the first new moon, after the first full moon, after the spring equinox. The word Easter is a Latin word. It means Esther, it means fertility. That's the celebration of the god of sex. And they twisted that thing around. My mother swore by the King James Version. She didn't know King James was King of England. She didn't know King James was such a weird, strange homosexual. He hated women so bad he killed his mother, and his lover was Lord Buckingham, who Buckingham Palace is named after. That was in my house. That's what raised me. She taught me the Tenth Commandment, thou shalt not kill, but it's okay to go to war and kill for this evil white boy. Huh? We sit around and say to the black woman, the problem in the black community, ain't no black man at home. Well, tell that to the Italians, who's the epitome of family values, huh? 98% of the mob is Italians, not 90% of the Italians are mob. Talk to them. Tell them about it. We go to the movie and we see Godfather and all of that, and they want to tell a black woman, the problem ain't no black man at home. Well, what about the mob? Hitler had a mother and father at home. Okay? You know, all these folks work in the nuclear plants, most of them had mothers and fathers at home. Why is it when it's my turn, there's something wrong? If I go to war and get killed, okay, my family's okay, but if I just leave on my own, it's not. And so one day when we realize what this whole thing is about, it ain't no accident that 98% of thyroid tumors is black women. The next highest amount is Jewish women. What they got in common? Nappy hair.
Nappy hair.
I dare you to change something that the universal God made. Mm-hmm. And so my mama didn't have fibroids. Her mother didn't have fibroids. When did fibroids start? When we introduced perms to our hair. The chemicals, okay? The chemicals. And so right now, if you go to the doctor, black men, hear this. Black men is 4% of America's population. 92% of prostate cancer death is black men. Huh? Black women is 6% of America's population. 98% of fibroids is black women.
Perm.
And nobody's saying, wait a minute, hold it. What is this about? This is almost impossible. How can this happen? Don't what nobody are we believe doing wrong?
That white people huh? are evil enough to create this.
It's yeah.
Just, don't nobody is, want to believe
ridiculous.
It.
Yeah, they want to give Dr. them the human benefit of the doubt. Dr. Goulston
has a point. Yeah, the proof is everywhere.
Mr. Gregory. I call you Mr. Yes, Gregory because we're not brothers. I'm the white guy in the show here. And I want
to... Let me tell you something, brother. White ain't a color. It's an attitude. And if you ain't got trillions of dollars in the bank, you can't have the attitude.
I don't know.
Queen Elizabeth makes $360 million every 24 hours just interest on her money.
Okay, I want you to honor my little attitude I'm going to bring out because I'm trying to listen to everything you say because you are one of the smartest, wisest people who has earned the right to be listened wherever you go, and I am having trouble staying tuned in. So this is just a little Whitey Locks comment. That's my nickname here. Is that when you have so much to share and tell, you can't do stuff that distracts from it. I mean, as a white person, as a white person, as I'm listening to this, I'll say he is smart. He's been around the bend and then some. He has earned the right to my respect, but you're not keeping my attention. And part
well,
of it,
let me
it, it
this,
no, it's
let
because your brilliance,
this,
is being your brilliance is being
People
distracted by
he said
this
about me one time I was too loud.
With the most
said
beautiful
I was too
woman
loud.
In the world, a black
go ahead,
woman.
Go ahead, go ahead.
We was here millions of years for anybody else, and I need some white person to validate my beauty?
Thank you.
Huh? I'm not trying. Look, you deserve to be heard by white, black, and everyone, and I'm just
let
speaking
me tell
as
you
a
something.
White person.
98% of my audience is white folks all over the world. Mm. Okay? There's some whites. They don't come there for respect. They come to hear what I have to say, and then they can go back and check it, okay? Go back and check it. When you walk into college, you're not there. If you want to be a chemist, you're there to learn chemistry, not to be in love with the damn teacher. And if they're not teaching right, you leave and you go someplace else, okay?
Yeah, but you deserve to be listened to beyond the audiences that you speak to. I mean, your message is that important, and it's distracting because of all the passion. I understand that. So
there's a book out on the market today.
What's the book?
101,001 people who made America. I'm listened to in that. I'm listed in that, okay? They go back before the Mayflower, okay? All right? So I do not elevate myself by talking on radio shows. I don't know who I'm talking to, okay? I do that out of respect because black folks made me, okay? They listened to me when I wasn't even funny. Mm-hmm. And when I got through, they pushed me all the way downtown when they couldn't afford to pay and see me. And out of all the money and all the fame I got, I've always been listed in the phone book, okay? I've never traveled with a bodyguard, okay? I don't tell anybody else to do it, okay? They wanted to pay me $40,000 4 years ago to come to Canada to be the Father of the Year. I say, something's wrong with that. Y'all don't even celebrate Father's Day. What's that about? So I cannot come. I cannot come for this reason. I have 10 children, okay? And those 10 children didn't come from me. They came through me, okay? And so when those babies are born, that means the real God gave me the pleasure to produce another God. Mm. It didn't say, what color are you? It didn't say, do you like me? It gave me, it didn't say, where do you live? How much education can you read or write? That's the privilege the universal God gave me. And I had 10. And when I look in the mirror at myself, I don't have to listen to who you say I am. I know who I am. And when I look in the mirror,
Mr. Gregory,
I see something. Wait, no, let me finish this. I see something that have created 10 gods and never had an affair with my wife to create another god. I was just getting me some booty. Okay? All right.
Okay, Mr. Gregory.
And I look back now.
Okay.
And realize I never bought a car. I didn't know the year, the make, the model, the down payment, the monthly notes and shit. I realize I put more planning into owning a damn car than creating God's new life. Mm. I am part of the problem, okay?
Mm. All right. Mr. Gregory,
I'm
you
going
look
to a peace rally in 2 weeks where my ticket costs $38,000 round trip. Mm. Okay, first class. Now, listen, when I pay the tax on that, this government takes my tax money and buys bonds and gas and drop on children and women around the world. So when it falls on my wife and my grandchildren, I can just look up and say, hey, Pop, what took you so long? Okay?
Wow.
All right?
Wow.
Mr. Gregory, you have more than earned the right for all of us and our listeners to listen to you. What I'm trying to ask, let me ask you this. What would it take for the people here, not me, to earn the right to be listened to in response to you? You have earned the right for us to listen to you.
Look, if somebody was explaining Hitler and the Nazis, if they knew what they was talking about and you was interested in that, then you listen. You know how many vegetarians don't know Hitler was a serious vegetarian? Hitler didn't drink, didn't cuss. Humans are supposed to be in bed 90 minutes after the sun goes down. Hitler violated all of that. What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? We sit around now and talking about don't ask, don't tell. Wait a minute. Don't ask, don't tell? Did y'all ever see George Washington with them tight silk pants on? Them semi-high heel shoes? A damn wig and makeup on? And y'all think this is something that just happened? I'm talking about a country that last year raped 10,000 more women and boys than they did the year before.
Wow.
I'm talking about Americans. If they do that to Americans, what do you think they're doing to foreign women overseas? Huh? That's what we're trying to move that level to, that where they can't trick you and go through all of that. Now, I want you to hear this, and then I'm going to shut up and go to your questions. Listen to this.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to this. For those of you that's too young to know about the Oklahoma City bombing, okay? That was the bombing of a federal building. They arrested
91?
A couple of people.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to hear this. This came out the Washington Times. This is the number one right-wing paper in America. The date is Wednesday, April the 22nd, 1998. Headlines, FBI paid mortgage on Terry Nichols' home. Denver, the FBI made mortgage payments on Terry Nichols' home after he was arrested, or before he was convicted for conspiring to blow up the Oklahoma City Federal Building. Court documents say, we went to court and made them release that, right? The Justice Department, this ain't just some punk in the street. The Justice Department spokeswoman said, she did not know immediately why the government was making his mortgage. She didn't say he didn't do it, nor did she know how much. The mortgage payments was disclosed in a court finding Monday by Nichols' lawyers, who argued that their client does not have sufficient assets to pay the fine. Now, this is the New York Times didn't run that. The Washington Post didn't run that. It happens every day, okay? Every day. The people that we trust, okay? The people that we trust. You look at that plane that's missing in Malaysia.
Flight 370.
They told us everything about Malaysia. Those of you who have ever been to Vegas, here's what they didn't tell you about Malaysia. Malaysia would make Vegas look like a picnic for baby nuns. Malaysia is the most filthy. It's the place where rich, rich billionaires play. You go to Malaysia, and you can book your time. You come in, you can book a six-year-old girl or three.
That's
and when
it.
You get
come
there,
on.
The girl's in the bed waiting on you. Now, we got all this press talking about everything in Malaysia, but they never tell us what that. Why would a little pipsqueak government like that have all of these thousands of planes at the airline? Why? Because it's the playground for rich freaks, okay? Now, what they haven't told you, that on that plane was 20 passengers who were scientists.
Uh-oh.
Okay?
Uh-oh.
Okay? Malaysia plane, here's an article. 20 passengers work for electronic warfare and military radar, where Uh-oh. They work for a month, out of Austin, Texas. Okay? And so all of this, now they haven't told us who they are. They told us that there's 20 scientists on the plane. Four of them scientists had filed for patents, okay? The patents is worth about $400 billion, okay? Now, the fifth person on them patents with them was the Carlyle Group.
That's Bush and them.
Okay, now watch this now. The patents was not granted till 3 days after the plane disappeared. which means if four of us had filed these patents and we disappeared or died before the patents was granted, that's null and void. Oh, you got one person that wasn't on the plane. The Carlisle Group gets all of that, okay? Hmm. And if you want to know where that plane is, it's in a group. It's on the island called the Island of Nega Garcia. It's a military, Navy military base for the United States of America.
Can you say that again, okay? Dick?
Diego Please. Garcia.
Diego Garcia.
Diego Garcia.
Diego yeah. Garcia. And what surprised me is one day we looking through this here because we're going to a conference and I'm looking through all of that, and I cannot believe ABC actually mentioned that. And then 20 minutes later, it was snatched off, never to be heard on ABC again.
Mm.
And so that's what's good about this 44,000 internet radio stations out here now that you don't have to depend on ABC and CBS and NBC.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how many of you all in the room or in the audience know, since January the 1st, there has been 18 top bankers around the world, they say, have committed suicide.
Yeah, okay? Dropping off like flies.
Okay? I didn't 18. Hear what you said, miss.
18 top bankers that have committed suicide is what he said.
All you got to do is pull out your Google and they Google
said.
It now.
He said all you got to do is Google it right now.
Yeah.
I've been watching it.
On ABC. But even if they didn't commit, they were murdered. But let's see if they didn't. When you got 18 top bankers around the world that have committed suicide, how come the local papers here haven't ran it? They just play it straight. One guy shot himself 8 times. They call it suicide.
Wow. Wow.
Well, this is what it's about. And there's a group of us all over the world. We meet. We spend millions of dollars to get the truth. I mean, we sit and looking at something as innocent as Trayvon Martin.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me tell you what they told us. Anybody know what they bought at the store? He did? Any?
I think
he bought
Skittles.
Skittles, Arizona iced tea.
Yeah, Skittles and iced tea.
Skittles and Arizona.
Anybody there know once you mix Skittles and iced tea together, you get a drug hit 3 times stronger than crack cocaine and heroin? Huh? All right? Now, how can all these folks be telling us all? Have you ever wondered why you listen to a murder news and they tell you about more of what he bought than about the homicide? Okay? If you live in a gated community, you pay extra money. And one of the things you pay extra for, everybody comes in that gate or out of that gate, okay, is video. How come they never showed us a video picture of him leaving, going to the store, or coming back, huh? All right? Do you know he laid in the morgue for 4 days as a John Doe? Huh?
Wow.
As a John Doe, his mother's calling the police station every day, and they got him listed as a missing person. You can't go to the morgue without a cop signing off on it, okay? They didn't know that was him. Now, listen to the story that they told us. They said he was living with his father for 2 weeks. He lived in Miami.
Mm-hmm.
He said they was looking at the All-Star game that night, All-Star basketball game. Okay? During the halftime, they said he went to the store. We all do that during halftime. We get on the phone, we call people, we run down, fix us a ham and cheese sandwich, and then we come back.
Mm-hmm.
Here's what they didn't tell you. He was killed that night at 7:17 p.m. The All-Star game didn't start till 8 o'clock. Huh?
Mm.
You mean the New York Times didn't know that? All this big lie that they bring out, somebody didn't know this? And they kept pumping it and pumping it and pumping it. And so now all of a sudden there's a group of people that have always known this kind of stuff, right? Always known this kind of stuff. And they can't, it's hard. They can't play that game no more like they used to. Oh, JFK was shot because what he's doing for Negroes. Are you serious? JFK signed an executive order. An executive order, when you sign it, it takes six months to go into effect. He signed that executive order on June the 4th, 1963. Okay? And the executive order is executive order 11110. Okay? All you got to do is type it up and look at it. That executive order was to do away with the Federal Reserve Bank. Okay? Now, go 100 years before that, to to 1863, Abraham Lincoln signed the executive order to do away with the central bank. And yet the history is so messed up the way they run it, you think both of them was shot, gunned down because of the Negro. Mm. Had nothing to do with that, okay? And so there's many of us out here that got teams of people out here that's searching in the stuff, and then we find it, and there's an audience out there now that we can give it to, that will listen, that will do research, will do their homework on it. Mm-hmm. And so consequently, we talk about chemtrails. Chemtrails, Indiana. Chemtrails, we see them every night, according to where you live. And when the chemtrails hit, it's lead and manganese. And they got ways of aiming it into the black community, to the Hispanic community. And once you get enough manganese, you will kill your mama, okay?
Mm.
And yet and still, they got us believing all this craziness in the black community, the drive-by shootings. Well, there's certain questions you have to ask. If I'm a Negro and I'm so trifling, I just get in a car and drive by and shoot black folks, how come they're not shooting no women? Huh? Where, where they get that integrity from, huh?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's organ stealing. If you look at 98% of the drive-by, they are headshots, okay?
Wow. You know what? Speaking of that, Brother Gregory, could you please talk about the Pope and the case against him? When you talk about the organ stealing and harvesting of these children, can you talk about this? Because it's not in the news real big.
Well, y'all sitting there, do me a favor. The new Pope is there. Just punch in the dirty Pope. Don't even put no name in it and see what his name pops up.
The dirty Pope. Oh, we're going to do that right now.
I got a movie to go like that.
And so when Benedict got busted, okay, they had found that they had safe houses in Italy, safe houses, where he would bring his big-time donors and his friends and various priests and folks, and they would have male sex prostitutes work there. What they didn't know is these safe houses was built by the mafia in Italy. What they didn't know is the number one television network in Italy is run by the mafia. So they found out the mafia was filming everything, and then they shook the Pope down for over $1.5 billion. When they asked for more, it was a group of people said no. That's why he had to resign. Okay? And if you punch up on your computer, February the 2nd, Groundhog Day, has nothing to do with it. February the 2nd of, not this year, last year, okay, 13, all Vatican credit cards were suspended around the world because they found out they was laundering drugs, they was laundering teenagers and little tot girls, they was laundering drug money and everything. Now, don't ask if somebody got the computer there. Pull it up.
We got it. I'm looking at it right now. I'm reading it.
What does it say?
It says, the new Pope, this is the New Yorker, it says, Pope Francis and the Dirty War. It says, the new Pope, Francis the Humble, as he perhaps would like to be known, is an Argentine with a cloudy past. This is itself is not an offense, but rather is in keeping with a religious institution that has been long marked by secrecy. From the smoke signals with which the papal conclave makes the fact, if not the process of its decision known to the world, to the wide-ranging cover-ups of sexual abuse involving priests and bishops, the Catholic Church is too often associated in the popular imagination with the darkest kinds of institutional opacity. In other words, they don't want nobody to see what's cracking.
Yes, yes.
Well, my mother sent me to Catholic school. The priest that was there, he went to jail for fucking little boys.
The school you went to.
I want to know which ones don't go to jail.
He went to jail for fucking little boys. And my friend, who's a comedian named Godfrey Danchema, he was getting into that stuff about going into priesthood, and he told me as he went, they got some type of school you go to or something. He basically said, hey man, all those people are homosexual. That's what he said.
Wow.
Hey, here's some more of the story.
It says some of the cloudiness. It says some of the cloudiness in France's past has to do with his relative obscurity during the years when he was still known as Jorge Mario Bergoglio. I don't know how to say his last name. Bergoglio. I don't know how to say that. And with the way that the church operates in even the calmest times, but much of it has to do with the questions about his real role during the country's anti-communist terror three decades ago.
Now, let me finish that for you. The juntas would go in, okay, with the cardinal's consent, and they would raid villages, and they'd take the men and the women. They would kill the men. They'd put the women in little places where they could be impregnated by the right-wing military. And once they got pregnant, after the 9 months was over, they'd take the baby and put them in helicopters and drop them in the ocean, okay? He knew about all of that, okay? And now it's beginning to come out because there's a new group of mentality out here. And if somebody were to Google that other piece where we were talking about the Vatican credit cards being canceled.
I'll Google it right now.
Hey, Dick Gregory, okay. this is comedian Corey Hogan. I just got to say this to you because this is something that happened right before my eyes. The guy that was here, Dr. Goulstein, the first time I ever met him and I was talking, of course not as eloquently as you speak, but I was talking about things that happened with black people and white people in America, he told me that I was loud or I was coming across the wrong way. And I told him, well, it's because I'm saying something you don't want to hear. So today, he tried to do the same thing to you, but you wouldn't even allow him to speak. And you just don't know how much you, it feels so good because he left. And I feel like he left because he wasn't able to come with his little manipulation questions and observations that he do that a lot of people respect because he has a quiet voice, because I talk like this. So you don't even know what happened in this room, man. That it's just another way you keep winning. You keep winning.
Well, remember one thing. Wolfman never talked loud.
Wolfman never talked loud.
Dracula never talked while he's sucking your blood.
Dracula never talks while he's sucking your blood. Listen, I found the story here. Debit and credit card purchases shut down at the Vatican. And these are major sources. This is the New York Times. This is the New York Times right here, right? So, I mean, the brother is saying some things that are pretty heavy. All of this stuff is going on under our nose. How do they keep all of the conspiracies so quiet? How do we not know what's happening when
you
it's
don't
obvious?
Know. Let me give you an example. Let's say I'm your brother, right? And you married, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And got 4 children. You and your wife are the pillars of the town. Your wife is head of public education for the county with a $3 million budget, okay? You are head of the big bank. First time a black person had that. All one day, your daughter come in, she's 4 years old, and she says to your wife, you know, Daddy's brother been putting his hand under my dress. Now, what happens to your face when your daughter tell you that?
Oh, yeah, it wrinkles up like bad.
Okay,
like,
now, it turns, it goes right in my closet and gets my 30-06 shotgun.
That's what.
No, well, see, that's the ignorance y'all talking now. We talking about a 4-year-old girl, when she see your face like that, she thinks she did something wrong.
Yeah.
Okay, so y'all run around talking this crap off this lingo, but when you go to a brain surgeon, you don't get some nigga on the corner telling you about your brain. You go find someone that's had the right scientific education. That's how we do. We got a group that do that, okay? We don't want to be told some stuff on emotions. When you start finding out certain things, why is it, out of all the black cops in America, thousands, you never saw a white person on the news or TV or the radio crying because this Negro cop shot my father in the back of the head 40 times. Why you think that don't happen? You think black cops are better trained? You think they're more spiritual? They know white folks ain't going to tolerate it. No more. Okay? Mm. Now, let's look in the black community. Black men. Hmm? Black men. Mm-hmm. In America. How many times have you heard a black man talking about this white cop took his nightstick and beat up my car? They never hit your car because they know you will not tolerate it. Shoot my mom in the back of the head 40 times, shoot my grandchild, and then tie him up and hang him. But don't mess with my car. Hmm?
Mm.
Okay? So we sit around and we talk about, but we want to leave out all the things that have happened to black folks. You got soldiers that go to war for 3 months and come home and wipe out their whole family. And they got a name for it, some kind of syndrome. This been happening to me for 300 years, and nobody's treated me for it. So you and everybody else will blame it on me, all right? Just like the whole thing with the Jews. A Jew killed Christ. Oh, wait. Well, the Jew told the Romans. Okay, mama, the Romans killed Christ. Let me tell you something. If I come there and pick one of you all out in the studio and tell a guy you need to be dead and to kill you, they do not arrest me for murder. They arrest me for something else, but it won't be murder. So how do a Jew kill Christ? Huh? A Jew kill Christ? And we know the Romans killed him. Something I didn't find out till I was a grown man. I thought they created a cross to kill Jesus Christ.
Hmm. Hmm?
I didn't know the Romans invented the cross 1,000 years before Jesus was born. Well, wait a minute. Yeah, they used the cross to kill certain people. They used the hatchet to behead certain people. Hmm? And they used hanging. And so what was the cross for? It was for revolutionists. Hmm? Revolutionists.
Hmm.
If you was a rebel, now remember, now go back. They didn't have cars and automobiles and all trains in the news. So if you and your mother, you got to go get the water from the creek, and you see this man hanging on the cross, and he's going to be there for 3 days, why? Because your mother is going to explain to you, your father, that he was a revolutionist. And this is what happened. So as a little child, as a human being, you know there's something wrong with being a revolutionist. That's what the cross was for, so people could see you there. Well, then the next question is, then what was them two thieves doing up there? Were they revolutionists?
Hmm? Mm.
Were they revolutionists? What's this about, huh? And so when you stop and think about that, now there's a new thing happening. In 1985, a new group of children was being born, not by Citizen Roebuck, not by the First National Bank. They're called the Indigo Children. Any of y'all ever heard of that?
Yes.
They're born with IQs of 200, and they go up, huh? Then after that came the Crystal Child. And now this year comes the fifth child. That one you can shoot, and it will never stop, okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's what we into while we're sitting around here playing all this other stuff. That the real stuff that's coming down, Henry Kissinger.
Oh, where is he?
Oh no,
I'm here.
Oh, okay,
oh, who?
We dropped you for a second. You said something about Henry Kissinger, and then it all went bad.
Oh, no.
So listen, Brother Gregory, we got to take one quick break. Then we're gonna come back and let you finish that. Okay.
Okay, good.
All right, we take it a quick. This show is crazy. It don't need us. We just need the elder to speak on it.
Yeah.
And it's going to happen, you know? We'll be back in 2.2 seconds, yo. T Radio V, the Zo What Morning Show is burnt to the ground. We'll be back.
Everyone, this is Rob Van Dam telling you you should watch RVD Live every Wednesday at 1 p.m. where we talk about whatever we want to. RVD outside of the ring, looking at real life. Every Wednesday at 1 p.m. right here on T-Radio V. Dude, radio and TV, who knew?
Party time! Hi, I'm Katie Cleary.
And I'm Kristen Renton.
And we're from World Animal News.
World Animal News discusses animal issues from around the world.
News that matters. Watch World Animal News every Thursday at 11 a.m. Find out everything about me on Twitter at Katie_Cleary and
at Kristen Renton.
So for those of you who don't know, this is Pepper.
Hey,
Pepper's in the house.
Yo.
How are you, Pepper?
How are you?
Yeah, I noticed a new one, like insignia change, and like, is that intentional or is that just like a refresher?
Oh, you mean the logo?
I called it insignia. I felt like I was like, we're in Lord of the Rings right now.
It really?
We have an insignia, people.
Yeah. To me, I thought it was like that new wave, like jazzy. Oh yeah,
I love that song. Speaking of which, we should all get that branded on us now because it's an insignia.
Okay.
The LA Music Blogcast, Thursdays at 8 p.m. only on T Radio V.
Radio V.
I found the greatest invention this week. It's a bed that's made for cuddling. It's called the cuddle mattress. And look, you can slot your elbow in.
Oh, my.
And what about the remote? That's my biggest concern.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you would seriously.
I already lose my remote and I have a normal bed and it gets like caught in my blanket. Yeah.
You shag in one and then when you get it all like wet and messy, you sleep in the other. And that's kind of what you need in life. You need like a bed to shag in and a bed to sleep in.
It's the Suicide Girls, Thursday, 6 p.m. on T Radio V.
Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, back in the building. I gotta tell you, this show is off the charts. Listen, I met a few wizards in my day, and what I've learned is when I'm in the presence of a wizard, like, I just shut up.
Shut your pothole and
I
listen.
Just listen.
Lay back.
Right? I just learn because there's no way my body of knowledge can compare to the brother that's on the phone or say Bobby or, you know, there's just no way. So what I tend to do.
Put my sword back.
I sheath my sword and I let the master Jedi take the scene.
Yeah.
And that's what we're experiencing here right now with Brother Dick Gregory. He doesn't have to apologize for who he is.
That's right.
He done put the work in.
Yeah.
You know, I got an uncle who's in his 60s, late 60s. He said, what? You got Brother Dick Gregory on the show. He was at UCLA when I was 19. I had just graduated. He said, that was the dude. He said he still is the dude. So when we bring him on because we know he can edify and our spirits with his information, with his wisdom, and all we have to do is fall back. So with that said, Brother Gregory, I got so many questions about conspiracies. Who killed Tupac and Biggie? Who was the real Michael Jackson? Like, you knew who Michael Jackson really was. My whole thing, tell us what's on your heart to say to us right now about conspiracies and how it affects our community. What do we need to know? How do we defend ourselves against it? How do we learn what you know?
Well, first, you can't. That's like you asking a brain surgeon that's 80 years old, how do we learn what you know? You ain't gonna get on a radio show.
Mm-hmm.
You get the appetite to go look at the real stuff. Punch up on your computer while we talking. Kennedy's brain is missing. Now, how you got the president of the United States, the most powerful person in the world, get shot in Dallas, and between that, somebody can come in and get his brain?
Mm.
And then after you punch up the coffin that he was buried in, they dug that up and threw it in the ocean. Why? Because folks listen to shows like this and they're going to exhume that coffin one day and they're going to find a horror story. That's why they're able to do it. Did the New York Times tell you this? No. Did the folks on the Evening News tell you this? No. They know the mentality. What I was saying to the brother just now, to get back to all at once, find out that I'm his brother and I'm tamping with his daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Mama, he's world renowned. He's a black woman, and she runs the largest educational county in the world. The brother is president of a major white bank. So now y'all got to call the police on me once you find out I did it. But there's something inside of you that want to hear my side, because can we afford to be embarrassed around the world from one of the top black money ladies and money men in the world to reduce down that your brother raped your daughter? So I'm looking for him to tell me. And then I come in and say, yeah, man, you know, she ain't never liked me. She's always lied on me. And the more you say it, the better it sounds.
Wow. Hey, Brother Gregory, we're at the end of the show. Man, I got to say this to you really quickly. I am deeply appreciative of you taking the time. I love you, brother. I love you, and I wish and hope that I can meet you one day. Hopefully when you're in L.A., you can come in studio. But we got to have you on this show, and we got to have you on this platform.
But I'm going to say this as I leave.
Mm-hmm.
When somebody told you to get me, you had to call who to get me?
Daryl Mooney, one of the Mooney twins.
And then after Daryl Mooney, he had to call my wife.
Yes, sir.
After the millions of dollars I made and make, I've never had a checking account. She handles all of it.
Yes, sir.
Because I know who that black woman is.
Ooh.
The most powerful, powerful. And I'll leave you with this. Hurricanes,
huh?
Is the spirit of a black woman. All hurricanes start in West Africa at the same spot black folks was put on the ship.
That's right.
All hurricanes stay on the water and follow the same ship that follow the same path that the slave ship followed.
Wow.
No slave was offloaded the ship till it got to the Caribbean. Huh?
Wow.
You hear me?
Yes.
Well, no slave was offloaded the ship till it got to the Caribbean. No hurricane jumps above water till it get to the Caribbean.
Wow.
And will hit this country called America and go all the way up the East Coast to Maine.
Mm-hmm.
And none of them even know this and none don't. Maine is as close to Canada as your telephone or your radio is to you. Why you think Canada's never had a hurricane? Because Canada never treated a black woman like America did. There's a universal God that don't have to explain to you what has happened. Okay? The payback is not you. If you get mad at me and go and want, that's like taking air out your own tire. If you was in Europe now and I was in Europe and you was selling crack and I was selling Vaseline petroleum jelly, I'd get more time than you. Why? Vaseline petroleum jelly is made out of gasoline, and you rub it on your babies. You put it on your lips. That's the ignorance they got us in. Okay? Vaseline petroleum jelly. It's right there in the name.
Wow.
Huh?
Wow,
and
brother.
So consequently, we sit around and think about this and that, your PhDs and all of that crap. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something real quick.
Really
Steve
quickly.
Steve Jobs, remember?
Steve Jobs, Apple.
When he died in his personal checking account, I'm not talking about the real one, at $300 billion. In his personal checking account. I got a cousin in St. Louis, little jackleg thug, man. He drink bad whiskey, cheap whiskey, cuss out everybody, fights every time. That nigga's 104. Steve should have followed him.
Oh. Hey,
everybody
thank you, brother.
Come to me and said, I'm overweight, how can I lose weight? I say, follow a hoe. You ain't never seen a fat hoe.
Thank you.
Just follow him. See what they
yeah.
Brother
Gregory,
let me see this.
We got to run. We got to run, but I need you to come back, brother. I really appreciate
it. All
you
have to do is call my wife, and she books. She's called me 5 times this morning because she know my plane. So you know you got this show to do. She takes care of business.
Okay. Thank you, sir. We appreciate it. We
got
to wrap.
Peace to you.
Margo, Bobby.
Peace to you. Thank you,
everybody. Man, I appreciate y'all. We are so pressed for time right now. We gotta go. We'll be back next week with another heater, man. This shit was crazy.
Yes.
We'll be back. Oh!
You are watching T Radio V. Radio and TV.